Do not miss any of our cool videos. Subscribe to our channel for latest updates. Click on the bell icon now.
Hello everyone, and welcome to our tutorial on creating a two-wheel Bluetooth controlled car using Arduino Uno and a motor driver sheet. So in this video, we'll go step by step about the assembly of the car and wiring along with the code and explanation. So without wasting any more time, let's just dive into it. Let's start by introducing the components we'll be using for making the Bluetooth controlled car. So the components include Arduino Uno. An Arduino Uno is the central processing unit for your project. It's a versatile controller that forms the foundation of your Bluetooth controlled car. Next, we have motor driver shield, which acts as an interface between the Arduino and the motors. It allows you to control the speed and the direction of the motors effortlessly. We are using HC05 Bluetooth module, which enables wireless communication between your smartphone and Arduino Uno. It lets you send and receive commands, facilitating remote control of your car. We'll be using a couple of 9-volt batteries with a DC male jack. The DC jack, which allows us to connect the batteries to the Arduino easily. We'll be using two wheels to provide movement, while the universal wheel aids us in maintaining balance and stability. They are crucial for cars' locomotion and navigation. We'll be using a couple of DC motors to provide necessary torque to drive your car. They are controlled by the motor driver shield and enables your vehicle to move forward, backward, left and right. Next up, we'll be using an acrylic chassis, which serves as a frame or the body of your car. It provides structural support, housing the motors, wheels and other components securely. So this is about all the components we'll be using in the Bluetooth controlled car. Now let's dive into the assembly. Let's start with setting up the chassis first. So as you can see, this is the acrylic chassis. Okay, and this position will be used for mounting the universal wheel. We'll start up with mounting the DC motors. For that, insert the fastener. This will come with the chassis. And mount your DC motor. So be careful while mounting the DC motor. These wheels should come in the opposite direction of your universal wheel. Okay, so use the screw to mount the DC motor on. Repeat the same process on the other side. After mounting the motors, mount your universal wheel. So for mounting universal wheel, you will need to use spacers. Okay, so first put the screw and the spacer to tighten it up. So this is how it will look after you mount all the four spacers. Next, we need to mount it on the chassis. For that, place it on the chassis such that these four holes matches the spacers positioning. Use the other set of screws and tighten it up using a screwdriver. This is how the chassis will look after assembling the universal wheel and DC motors. Let us quickly summarize the assembly so far. So starting with the chassis, we have inserted the fasteners and mounted the DC motor such that the nuts are on this direction. Okay, so it should be inside. It's always a good practice to keep them inside. And the positioning of the wheels PO motor should be on this side, which is opposite to the universal wheel. Okay, so that the balancing will be appropriate and the weights can be counterbalanced. So we'll mount the universal wheel using the spacers onto the chassis. So be careful about the holes. Okay, the holes should match with the spacers gap. Okay, so it should be aligned properly. Next up, we will be passing these wires from these holes. So it's always best practice to pass it from here so that it does not disturb any other connections. Okay, so this is how it will be on the other side. Next, we'll mount the wheels. Next up, we'll be mounting the Arduino Uno. We'll be mounting the driver shield on the Arduino Uno. Okay, mount it such a way that these pins should be aligned on this side. Okay, so as you can see, this is we in ground from 1 year. So this will go in like this, in this direction. So again, mounted in a way that the motor M2, as you can see, M2 and M1 should be on the DC jack side of the Arduino Uno. Okay, so M1 will always be the left motor. Okay, should connect the left side motor to M1. While doing the connections, be cautious and keep in mind that these red wires will come on the outer side and the black wires will come on the inside. Okay, so M1 is the left motor and M2 is the right motor. After this, we'll connect our Bluetooth module using some jumper wires. Okay. As for the Bluetooth connections, as you can see, we will be using VCC, ground, TX and RX. So VCC will go to the 5-volt pin here. And the ground will go to ground. Next, we will be connecting the TX pin of the Bluetooth to the A0 of the Arduino using this pin, the first pin here. And the RX will go to the A1, the second pin. This is about the Bluetooth connection. Next, we'll be connecting two 9-volt batteries for powering the driver and the Arduino. Okay, so first we'll be connecting it to the motor driver. After you connect the battery, this LED will start glowing. Next, we'll have to power the Arduino. Using this jack, we'll just insert it here. We'll connect the jack. And now your car is completely assembled. Let's start with the code explanation for Bluetooth controlled car. Okay, so here we are using two libraries, AF motor library, which will help us in controlling DC motor, and another one will be software serial, which will help us in communicating to establish communication between Bluetooth module and the Arduino. Next, we are initializing motors. So left motor, which will be connected to M1, and right motor will be connected to M2. And software serial will be using pin number A0 and A1. A0 will be RX and A1 will be TX. Next, in setup function, we'll be establishing the serial communication between the normal serial communication and the Bluetooth serial communication, which uses pin number A0 and A1. Next, we will be running the loop. We will be continuously reading the Bluetooth data whenever it is available. So whenever it is available, we'll read the character and we'll see what that character is. If the character is F, then the bot will run forward. If it is B, backward. And same is for left and right, L and R. And finally, we'll be using S character for stop. So after whichever character we receive, suppose if we receive F, then the forward function will be called, and forward function will make left and right both wheels rotate forward. And for backward, we will be making them to rotate backward. For left, the left wheel will be rotating backwards and the right wheel will be rotating forward. As for right, the left wheel will rotate forward and the right wheel will rotate backward. As for stop function, both of them will be released, that is, they will made to be stopped. So this is about the code explanation. After copying the code and pasting it, go here, select Arduino Uno and the port whichever is available. Verify the code and then upload it. So as soon as you have uploaded the code, your bot will be ready to use. As for the demonstration, for the purpose of controlling the car, we'll be using Bluetooth RC car controlled app, which you can easily get in your Play Store. Go to Play Store. Search by the name Bluetooth car remote control and you will get the app called Bluetooth RC car. Install and open. We'll open it as we have already installed. And as you can see, this is the interface you will be getting. Go to settings. Click on connect to car. As we have changed the Bluetooth name to Bluetooth car and we have already paired it, it's showing in the paired device section. But for you, if you are doing it for the first time, you will get the Bluetooth name as HC05. In other available device section. So click on that and pair it up. So now that we have paired it, we'll be connecting to Bluetooth car. Connect to Bluetooth car. Okay. So now the red light will be turned to green if your Bluetooth is on. Okay. So for that, you need to keep your Bluetooth turned on and try pairing it. So as soon as it is connected, you can see that the red indication is now turned to green. Okay, if you want to see what are the settings, what are the values which are getting sent when you use the control, go to settings and here scroll down, you will be able to see. So forward is sending F, backward B, left L and right is R. So we have given the same settings in the code. Now let's try using the bot. So from the interface, as you can see, we have the various buttons for controlling the direction. Some basic buttons which we will be using are forward, backward, right and left. Okay, so this is about the app which we will be using. Now let's try to control the Bluetooth controlled car. So as we have uploaded the code, let's go through the connections again. We have uploaded 2 9 volt batteries, one to the driver and one to the Arduino Uno, and we have connected motors to M1 and M2. So M1 is connected to the left motor and M2 is connected to the right motor. So this is the front and this is back. So and the wheel is mounted on the universal wheel is mounted on the back. As for the Bluetooth module, we have connected V in to 5 volts, ground to ground, and TX of the module to RX of the Arduino, that is VA0, and RX of the Bluetooth to the TX of the module, that is A1. And don't forget to use a jumper wire to connect this power pin. Okay, so this is very important, or else your motors will not get the power. So that's all about today's tutorial on building a two-wheel Bluetooth controlled car. Let us know in the comment section below if you have any queries. And if you want to access the code, we have given a blog link in the description. You can access it from there. So until next time, happy making.